The Extreme Bass Angler is presented by Go Fish in Ontario. It's catching. Strike King Lure Company, over 50 years of domination. St. Croix Rods, best rods on earth. Sportsman Protein Shake, power your obsession.
Fish right there. Look. Hey, fishing for largies in crystal clear water. Look. That's how we start our afternoon with a chunk. And my little plastic bait. Oh yes, look at that, eh? It's just a chunky little largemouth, eh? Let's put him back. Huh? Ready? Ready? Go on. When you're faced with ultra clear water, like I mean really clear, you can see like it looks like a glass of water, you have to find ways to catch those bass. You got a couple options. Go deeper, find weed and brush, edge of shoals, reefs, different kind of stuff. Or if you're like me, you pick up the heavy nasty stuff, like your heavy St. Croix, 20 pound edge, and your little plastic baits, and get into the nasty stuff. Every lake's got the nasty stuff, you just gotta find it. And on this lake up here in Eastern Ontario, we're fishing out of Opiongo Mountain Resort. And we're gonna look for largemouth that are habitating or sitting along reeds, weeds, logs, pads, you name it. The nasty stuff in clear water. You stay back, make those longer pitches, you are gonna catch them. So hopefully you'll learn some stuff in this segment, how to catch them when the water is clear as the water in your glass. Let's go. Incredible how shallow they sit. They are just like ghosts. That light green in the light clear water. Incredible stuff, boy. As long as their backs are wet, you can catch them. You just gotta put in the effort and be slow, methodic. Don't spook them. But as much as you try, you still get spooked. I can pick my spots, look for dark holes in the actual pads, or find some deep depressions, or find where it's thicker and stuff. And the mistake you want to make is go right into this stuff right away. Fish this outer stuff. That's a lot of those fish are the more aggressive fish on the outsides. Let's see if we can get some. Oh God. Wow, you talk about aggressive. Came out of nowhere, had it, and I missed them. They are so psychotic, they're actually missing it. They're so aggressive. They're so aggressive. Wow. Whoa. Turning on it. Rig back up. Put it back in. And we've just started. I can't believe it, man. Just goes to show you. When they don't have a lot of deep habitat, where do they go? Tight and shallow. Okay, when you're fishing this real shallow stuff like this, real clear water, I like that plastic. You know why? Because I got that little tungsten weight and it's smaller and it doesn't sink as fast into the mung. Another option, obviously, is the jig. Problem is, I saw a couple of fish with the jig. The fish came right out. The jig goes right inside that mung. It's about that thick, about 3 or 4 inches of just like muddy green moss, new weed and stuff like that. And the fish, they just didn't want to go inside that stuff to find it. So on days like this, when you're fishing real clear water and there's that mungy stuff, you know, either a couple options are a real light jig with a bigger chunk, so have a real slow fall, fish have time to come out to see it, or pick up the plastic with a small tungsten weight and put it in. And if you find that fish are missing it as well and it's going inside stuff, go to a little bit bigger bait, you know, with a bit more appendages and stuff like that, so it stays in that little zone of the foot or 18 inches a little bit longer. Fish came out of the edge of the pads, eh? Look at the scrapping bass, eh? Nothing wrong with those fish. Look how they get stuck. Oh boy, nice largies, eh? Just chunky fish, look at. Just chunks. Nothing wrong with those. Everyone loves the chunky largemouth. Look at, maybe 2 pounders. Look at the backs on them. Gorgeous little fish, eh? I love you, little guys. Let's put them back in here. And it, you know what? Sometimes, man, you can look where they are. You know, you say to yourself, okay, there could be right back thick inside that stuff where there's cane mixed in and stuff like that. But I've seen, and I admittedly spooked more fish on the outside edges. So that shows me they're aggressive, an aggressive bite on the outside edges. So, you know, give what the fish give you. They're telling you that, hey, we're on the outside edges here, we're feeding here, stick to it, keep doing it, pitching. You know, don't give in to temptation saying, boy, it looks so good in there. The magazines say go in tough, you know, get right in heavy stuff and throw a frog and stuff. But I wanted to throw the plastics in this stuff because I like that hand-to-hand combat with the soft plastics, my heavy action St. Croix, the 20-pound fluoro, and getting in there. But it's the edges today where they are, because those are the fish that want to eat. Let's go and let's pound some big ones. Come on. Here's some stuff to look for. See the reeds coming out like that there? And there's a small pocket and it's dark shadow. Then you got some opening. Then you look along these shoreline in front of these reeds again, where it's all the standing, and all of a sudden you see the thick stuff, pads, thick stuff, thick stuff. So you start dissecting and you see potential areas a little bit darker, a little bit thicker, maybe a little bit of depression of where those fish potentially could be hiding, especially in this real clear water. So you just take your time, you know, you got areas over here that are all open, but then you come over here and you can see that it's shadows, dark, thicker pads. That's the kind of stuff you want to pitch to. Take your time, go along, make your pitches so the bait doesn't make a big splash, just get in the water and hold it. A lot of times it's just mush or it's that traditional boom, because they're very authoritative. In this clear water, when they're there, only two things happen. They don't think about it, whatever. They're right on it or they take off. It's just the way it is. Sometimes you pitch behind a fish and spook him, he takes off. Most times if it's to the side or in front of him, he'll take an effort and go get it. If you land just behind a fish, they don't like that. They usually just take off. So keep those pitches in those dark little spots, potential stuff, then work out again to the edges, the deeper water. One lily pad right in front of me. See, fish move right there. Wow, what a scrapper, eh? Look at him go. Look at thick-bodied largemouth, eh? Awesome, awesome. You found that little plastic, didn't you, eh? Little fat belly. Look at them. Look at them. Eating up like there's no tomorrow. Man, oh man, oh man. Love it. Chunky little largemouth. Make my day. You fight pretty good for a little bass. Come on. Making the pitches. Pitching all over the place. After a while, you get to sort of read different things. That's like a little point. See how the weeds are all thick and all that? Comes out. And I pitched out and I saw a little swirl to the right. Just goes to show you how fast they can pick up on something that's falling in the water. I don't know if they think it's a frog or whatever, but it's something in their domain. Unfortunately for me, it's got that 4-odd wide gap hook. And see how I rig it here? I got a sliding worm weight like that, or sliding a float bobber stop, and I push it down onto that tungsten sinker so it holds that bait in place. That hook is just sits like that. They bite, it pops. If I'm fishing real heavy stuff, I can just text pose it a bit, not worry about much weed. But I'm pitching this thing into a lot of these pockets that are in this stuff, so I'm not too worried about getting, you know, hung up in a lot of weed and stuff. It's a higher hooking percentage as well too, and it can pop out. Let's go and let's maybe pop in some big ones. Here comes some more pads. What I'm going to do is position myself just right. The wind, I can make those longer pitches in this clear water. But the key is utilizing these power poles. Put them down. Now I can just dissect what I want. There's some pads in there. There's reeds and dark holes. Pads out here. Let's see what happens. Look at him, mate. Everything shallow. Just a chunky little bass. Look at him. Where were you, boy? I could have just drove by with my truck, stopped along the shoreline, and caught you. Cast almost out my window. That's how close to shore you are. Look at roads right there. bass. You don't care, do you? As long as it's covered and cold, put them back. Ready? Go on. Doesn't matter, man. I tell you, doesn't matter. You know, I'll bet you a lot of boats just launch and take off to the side of the lake and stuff. And really, the resort, I could probably order a sandwich and they can deliver it to me on the road right there. So sometimes, look out. Fish don't care, you know? What about the guys who are fishing on the other side of the lake? They come to this side. It's all relative. Look for the cover, especially in clear water. If there's cover present and largemouth need to find it, they will. Now, as for color, when I'm fishing really clear water like this, three choices are my favorite. I got like a watermelon or a green pumpkin and it has red and black flake. Second choice would be like that peanut butter jelly, PBJ, okay? Brown with a bit of purple, awesome. But today, they just definitely wanted that summer craw, with the green pumpkin, with the bright neon chartreuse. You say, well, you know, crystal clear water, natural tones and stuff. I just wanted to see it. There's the natural tone. There's the thing that maybe inspires the bites or just inspires that strike when they see it. But in the water, it looks always different to a fish. You know, looking at it with a human eye, fish see things much differently, especially when it's in the water, in cover and stuff. But you got to make sure that they see it before they can eat it. Okay. Buckets on fire in the clear water. You tell me how you're going to beat that. I know you'd say if they were 4 pounds, of course, everybody wants to catch big fish. But man, I tell you, just like when I flip docks, it's about how you fish sometimes. And fishing in this stuff, ready? Let you go, okay? Go on. It's how I'm doing it, enjoying it. One-on-one, punisher, right on top of those bass. Taking my time, stealth-like, and you still spook them. But man, oh man, it is so much fun. The soft plastics, the tungsten weight, 4-rod extra wide gap honer, 20-pound gamma edge, and my 7.4 St. Croix. This is lethal, okay? You should license this, because it's lethal. These things destroy bass. Closed captioning of this program, presented by Sportsman Protein Shake. Some longer pitches to this stuff right here. There's a fish there, he'll tell me, because he'll try to eat it. That's the thing with fishing this kind of stuff, boy. Stealthy. Stay back, put the poles down when you have to, and just dissect all the potential stuff that looks like it could hold a bass. Can I ask for tungsten weight? The heaviest I would go in the real shallow stuff is 5/16, quarter ounce and 3/16. It's not too light. As long as you can, you know, have free spool in your reel, make those longer pitches and stuff, don't worry. You want that bait to fall slow in this clear water, especially when you got mung and different things on the bottom. A lot of fish are picking it up off the bottom, so you don't want it to be stuck on the bottom and having to shake it and stuff, and they're just looking at it and stuff. You just spook fish. Line, definitely. Braid is an option, but when I like when the water is this clear, that gamma fluorocarbon edge, 20 pound, you can't beat it. And I got it with the Legend Xtreme by St. Croix, 7.4 heavy power. I use a 7.6 as well, the medium heavy for longer pitches and stuff like that, but keep it real simple. A really good rod, 20 pound line, 4-rod offset wide gap hook with a lot of different creature baits and the light tungsten weights. Whoa, good one too, look at this. Look at this guy fight, dude. Look, that's the kind of largemouth you get in clear water right there. Look at him. Wow. Oh, wow. Hey, keep your bait wet. That's what happens. Look at that hook. See that? Yeah, we'll take a picture of a couple of these fish, eh? What do you think? Hey, Mr. Big Mouth? Tell him.
Yes, yes. Go ahead. Take that picture and let me go.
I will. Crazy times. Opiongo Mountain Resort. Catching buckets in crystal clear water. Let's go. You're gonna dissect it. Just like you're dissecting in a dock, dissecting a boathouse, all over. And don't assume, because you look down, you don't see anything. Keep your bait wet, man. Those fish are like ghosts out here. All of a sudden, they're just on your bait. Crystal clear water. Like that. See? Sitting on the outside, huh? Can't beat it, man. Can't beat it. Fishing largies in clear water. I don't care, man. Where you fish. Look how clean those fish are, too. Ontario's got beautiful largemouths. Maybe we don't have the giants in the deep south, but boy, we got numbers. And man, do we have the lodges and lakes and opportunities. Come on down to good old Ontario, because the largemouth are waiting for you. Let's go. So making those longer pitches. Give them time to eat it, not see me. It's deep out here. That's why there's a lot of fish out here. Deep as in 3 feet as opposed to a foot and a half. That's a better one. Yeah, that one's crap. Think that one means it? That's a better one, hey? That's a better one. Chunky. I'll take some pictures of some of these fish. You know what? I've already got a good one for a picture. Let's let him go. Right back in the pads, huh? He fought. Look at the size of that mouth. Look at that, hey? Look at that. Gorgeous, chunky largemouth. Ready? Ready? Go on. Gone like the wind. It's a nice chunk. Beautiful. Come on, fish. Look for the irregular stuff in the regular stuff. Depressions. Heavier pad. Something that they can just hold to in this nasty cover. Shallow and clear. They'll find anything. But I'll keep my bait wet. You don't know when they come out of anywhere. Those ghosts. I like when you just feel the thunk. Thunk. You know he's got it. Like that. Yep. That looked too good not to have a bass, right? That looked too good not to have a fish. Oh, God. I love you, largemouth man. Especially if you're in the heavy, nasty stuff. Catching them in the nasty. Shallow nasty. Go on. That's how we do it. Crystal clear water. Long pitches for these bass, boy. Come on, fish. Is there any good ones in here? Where's a good one? 3+. Lake doesn't have a lot of big bass, but boy, it's got a lot. There's a largemouth. What a scrapper, eh? Sitting on the outside weeds, eh? Love it, man. Look at them go. Sometimes it's about how you're catching them, not the size. And man, they're just fun. Just pops out like that. Ready, boy? Huh? Throwing that little plastic in the crystal clear water. Like, I mean, it is crystal clear. And they're just sit there like statues. Your bait comes in, boop, gone. Whew. Sometimes when you see those fish, you know, it just happens. You know, you just spook them and stuff. You cast ahead because, you know, you didn't sting them, you didn't touch them. So cast ahead 6-10 feet of water and shake it a bit. It's called leading. Sometimes they'll come over and boop. So be prepared. Don't be distraught when you see them and they take off because they'll still bite. Here's what I'm talking about. Going into these pads and stuff like this here, right? You've got this weird grass, patches of it and stuff, and it's still, remember, it's crystal clear water. So those fish will use the same kind of grass out here. So while you're working in towards those pads, make your pitches to those grass patches in front of the pads. You can catch them too. Wow. Hey, another beautiful fish. I mean, you can't beat that. You can't beat it. Look how nice and chunky they are. You know, beautiful, beautiful chunk bucket mouth bass. Hello, bucket mouth. Wow, hey. Ready? Go on. Well, I don't know how many I caught today. You know, I came out just this afternoon. I only started around 11 o'clock, you know, after lunch. That's the greatest thing about coming to lodges and stuff. You can fish any time of the day. Get up early, get those nice smallmouth or topwater bass and stuff. But come out in the afternoons, like I have, and just pick apart the heavy cover in crystal clear water. It don't matter. You know, you just make your pitches long, stealth-like, take your time going through. If you have a smaller boat, use an anchor and put it down. Work the areas, but the key is, see these areas right here? There's like a little point in the weeds. There's all weed, and yes, there's fish all through there, but this little peninsula comes out like this. It just goes out to the lake. It is a magnet for these kind of largemouth in clear water. I hope you enjoyed the show as much as I did catching them. See you next time on the Xtreme Bass Angler for anything that swims that's called
The Xtreme Bass Angler has been presented by Young Steel's Ford Lincoln, Gamma Fishing Lines, Rage Tail Soft Baits, Interstate Batteries, Top Gun Marine. Visit us at fishxtreme.com. Watch us, like us, follow us, see us.